हेलो, गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स।
गुड इवनिंग सर।
ओके, गुड इवनिंग। सो ओके, लास्ट क्लास हाउ मच कंप्लीटेड इन इलेक्ट्रोकेमिस्ट्री? Hello. How much completed in electrochemistry?
So we did the current efficiency, and then we did numericals after that.
Faraday's laws numericals, huh? Numericals based on Faraday's laws, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. How many over? Can you read last problem? Anybody?
So it was in an electrolysis experiment, a current was passed for 5 hours through two cells connected in series. The first cell contains solution.
Yes, I got it. Okay. Next, one more problem. Do it. Then we'll go for the other concept. One or two problems after that. Some students are still has to join. Okay, right. Next problem. How long? What is the question number 4 or 5? I don't know. Simply, I'm giving number 5. How long? How long has a current? Is a current of 3 amperes. 3 ampere. To be applied through a solution of silver nitrate AgNO3 silver nitrate to coat
sir, you gave that question.
a metal given, huh?
Yes sir.
Okay, clear it now. Yes. So that I given, right? Okay, this is a previous asked question. Note it down. An ammeter and a copper voltmeter. Note down. An ammeter. And a copper voltmeter. Voltmeter are connected in series through which a constant current flows. grams of copper is deposited deposited in 1 hour. 1 hour. What is the percentage? What is the percentage error? Percentage error of the ammeter. Error of the ammeter. Ammeter. Yeah, read now. Read the question and think about what is the formula required. Okay, what is the amount of the electrode reaction? Take the solution now. First, write the electrode reaction. What is electrode reaction? Electrode reaction is Cu plus two electrons gives rise to Cu. Copper is reduction. That means here 1 mole of copper, 1 mole. Here 2 electrons means 2 into Faraday, 96,500 coulombs. Right. So what is the mass of copper deposited? Actually, it is 63.5 grams of Cu deposited by passing. What is that? That is equal to 2 into 96,500 coulombs. What you are given, how much is given? Amperes. 0.365 grams are given. So that means that is 0.635 grams of copper deposited by passing. That is equal to how much? 2 into 96,500 into 0.635 by 63.5. That implies that use rest how much? Okay, that is 2 into 965 coulombs. That is equal finally 1930 coulombs. Amount of copper deposited, right? Now, next. Space is not there, but now here only I am solving. Please note down that continuation part is. We know that what is the formula? Q is equal to I into T, right? So then I should find. So that is ampere. Okay, that is first find the I, then go for the percentage. So what is I according to that? I is equal to 1930 by time. Time is given. How much is given? Four. Where is the time is given? 1 hour. Ammeter of the system. 1 hour. So gram per deposited in 1 hour. 1 hour means 60 into 60 mm. That it becomes by calculating. So 0.536 amperes. 6 amperes. Now percentage error is equal to. What is the percentage error is given? 0.52. So already that shows ammeter color. Ammeter value is 0.52 amperes are there. So error means the difference by 100. Therefore, percentage error. Error is equal to 0. Calculated value is 0.536. Ammeter value is 0.52. So divided by 100. So by calculating what is the value, so 2.985. Okay, you can check it. You have the calculator is there. Okay, these model questions are there. I'll send that exercise. Now come to the next. Conductance and conductors. Next concept is conductances and the conductivity. We'll discuss that one. Okay, note it down, all of you. Okay, now. Now I'm removing this page. I'm going to another part. Take this next concept. Okay, hello students. Can I explain? Already I explained Arrhenius theory of electrolytic. Starting I explained or not Arrhenius theory of conductances.
Yes, sir.
The degree of dissociation?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, you have done that.
Yeah. Now come to this. Next heading. Conductance and conductors. So the electrolytic conductance, already the factors affecting the conductance will discuss, I think, the nature of the solutions, right? Now conductors are here, there are different types are there. Specific conductance, molar conductance, and equivalent conductance. Specific conductance and molar conductance are equivalent conductances. So electronic conductors we already discussed. Now we are going to the electrolytic conductors. Here now is nothing but discussing electrolytic conductors. So here electrolytic conductors are three types are there. Electrolytic conductors, three types. Specific conductor, equivalent conductor, and molar conductor. Now come to the conductances. See here, observe now here. Small diagram I'm drawing now. This is the electrolytic. Note on this diagram. These are the electrode plates. Parallel electrode plates are suspended into electrolytic solution by using platinum wires. These are the platinum electrodes, wires only, plus minus, right? The distance between two parallel plates, is the L centimeter. And this area of cross section of the electrode plates are a centimeter square. What is the area of? Now, you know, any electrolyte can offers the resistance to measure the conductance. You know, any electrodes, it has some resistance, right? So that based on that resistance only you can measure the conductance. Say generally the person, if the one person is very good, another person is not good. So not good person is very important person to measure the quality of the good person. Understood or not? Otherwise there is no how to measure the good quality. So anything is measured based on the unknown thing only. So that negative, where generally you are thinking is a negative quality, not negative quality. Negative also is a very strength compared to the positive. Due to negative only, positive, the value of positive increases. So like that here, electrolytes also, electrolyte, any electrolytes can offer the resistance. So based on that resistance, you can measure the conductance. Now, according to that, the conductance can be, that is the property of electrolytic conductor. The conduct resistance is directly proportional to, no doubt, the resistance is directly proportional to length of the, otherwise I am writing points what I am discussing. Any electrolyte can offer the resistance of the conductor, the electrolyte, resistance of the electrolyte is directly proportional to the length of the conductor and inversely proportional to length of the conductor and inversely proportional to area of cross section of the electrolyte. What is the resistance means R is directly proportional to length of the conductor L and area of cross section A. Inversely proportional to area of cross section. That means R is equal to some proportional constant rho into L by A. Now 1 by rho is equal to L by A into 1 by R. So what is the here 1 by rho is equal to L by A into 1 by R. You know 1 by rho means rho is the resistivity or specific resistance. R is the resistance. So 1 by rho means reciprocal of the resistivity is the conductivity K. It is called kappa. K is equal to L by A into 1 by R means reciprocal of the resistance means conductance C. This is the formula, final formula. Try to understand and note down. K is equal to, what is K? Resistivity or specific resistance. I'm writing here. I'll note down all formulas. All the terms you can write. R is equal to resistance. Okay. And rho is equal to specific resistance. Or resistivity. Next, here K, kappa, it is the conductivity or specific conductance. Conductivity are specific conductance. Specific conductance, right? And L by A is equal to cell constant. L by A is equal to cell constant. L by A is a cell constant. Okay. Note it down. Note down, all of you. Okay, clear? Okay, right. Next. See this one. What is the formula written? K is equal to L by A into C. This is the formula, right? Now, what are the units for this? Units for specific conductance. Units for specific conductance. Units for K. What is centimeter, right? Next, A means centimeter square into resistance 1/R. You know, R, resistance means ohm. So that means ohm inverse. Conductance means ohm inverse. Here centimeter cancel. So what is the final line? Ohm inverse. And centimeter inverse is the specific conductance units. Okay, this is on C, Simond also. S or centimeter inverse or meter inverse. So in SI units, so instead of ohm inverse, capital S you can, that is a Simond in SI units. This is the specific conductance. Okay, now we are going to take that molar conductance. Or equivalent conductance. Note it down. Molar conductance. So understood, all of you? Molar conduct. Now we are going to discuss the molar conductance. Come to now. Molar conductance. Next heading, molar conductance. Molar conductance. So this is the molar conductance. Yeah, what is meant by molar conductance means, say this is the just previous diagram only, short form I'm writing. This is observe the diagram. This is one wall, right? This is one electrolyte. Electrode plate only. Why the previous diagram, there's two electrode plates now. The electrode plates are separated by unit length. This is, what is the length here? This is L centimeter. L centimeter. And the area of cross section is A centimeter square. So this is the cubic unit volume. Cubic unit volume. So what is this one? Total electrolytic solution. Electrolytic solution. Now, what is meant by molar conductance? The conductivity of, that means the conductivity exhibited by one mole of electrolyte placed between two parallel plates, which are separated by unit length and unit area of cross section, or simply the conductivity of cubic unit volume of one mole, that is in terms of mole only, can express it. I'm writing, note it down. the conductivity of conductivity of one mole of electrolyte placed between two parallel plates which are separated by unit length and unit area of cross section, or simply, what is the definition? The conductivity of 1 gram mole of an electrolyte electrolyte of cubic unit volume, that is V or VML, VML, cubic unit volume, and it is represented by mu. Of course, here mu or cap mm. So in NCERT book it is a cap representation only, but in other books they are given mu or cap m. So right, so that mathematically expressed as mu. K into 1000 divided by molarity. So that means where V is the volume of ml containing 1 gram, or concentration, or m is the molar concentration of the electrolytic solution, then that is the formula. So mu is equal to K into, take this formula. What is this one? This is the formula, right? Mu is equal to K into 1000 divided by M. So where, what is the mu? Is the mu or cap M is the molar conductance, and M is the molarity of the electrolyte, and K is the specific conductance. So okay, note it down all of you. Next, we are going to discuss the equivalent conductance. Okay, can I replace this? Okay. equivalent conductance. Now next setting is equivalent conductance. Equivalent conductance or equivalent conductivity. See this, what is equivalent conductance? Same diagram, the cubic unit volume. What is the statement? So the conductivity of 1 gram equivalent, 1 gram, 1 gram equivalent of electrolyte placed between two parallel plates which are separated by unit length and unit area of cross section. Unit area of cross section is known as equivalent conductance, or the conductivity of 1 gram equivalent electrolyte in cubic unit, that is VML, unit volume, cubic unit volume. So that means conductance is equivalent conductance. So what is the mathematical relation, equivalent conductance formula? See, this is cap EQ, are represented as cap EQ is equal to specific conductance K into 1000 divided by normality. 1000 divided by normality. This is the specific conductance. K into 1000 by normality. So here, note down this formula and keep in box this formula and write the terms explanation. Where cap EQ is equal to equivalent conductance and K is equal to specific conductance and N is equal to concentration, means normality of the electrolyte. Normality of electrolyte. Okay, Nama? Okay, all of you understood? Hello, students. Hello. Pawan, yes. Following.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Any doubt?
No, sir.
Krishna?
No, sir.
Akshay?
Yes, sir.
Anushuda?
Yes, sir.
Tell me now, what is the molar conductance?
Sorry, sir?
What is the molar conductance definition?
It's written, equivalent conductance.
Molar conductance definition.
Oh, I didn't follow that, sorry.
You didn't write?
I didn't follow that, sorry.
What is equivalent conductance?
The conductivity of 1 gram equivalent when the electrode is placed between two parallel plates.
That's all. What is the formula for equivalent conductance?
Yeah, it's K into 1000 by N. It's written on the board. Specific conductance into normality of the electrolyte. I mean, into 1000 by a normality of the electrolyte.
Okay, Nidhi?
Yes, sir.
Do you know what is the specific conductance definition? Specific conductance or conductance? Conductivity, sorry. Specific conductance or conductivity definition? Any given definition?
So you haven't given that definition.
You can identify that definition based on formula. You can define.
So is it the conductivity of an electrolyte when unit length, like through a unit length and area of electrolyte?
Yeah, very good. That's it. That only. Same, all of you listen now. So what is the specific conductance definition? Specific conductance, I'm showing now. What is the formula? K is equal to L by A into C. Now, here L is equal to 1 centimeter. If L is equal to 1 centimeter and area of cross section 1 centimeter square,
sir,
from that, hello?
Sir, you made us write this thing in the previous topic, right? Conductors and conductance.
Next page, previous page required,
No, no, sir. I'm asking that you made us write. Why are you making us write this again? Like you made us write.
Achha, again, explanation is required.
No, sir. I'm asking why are you making us write again? Like you had
I'm not right. I am not writing definition only. So K is equal to L by A into C now. How to define, sir. I am saying now. If L is equal to 1 centimeter, A is equal to 1 centimeter square. So then what is it from equation one, this equation one. So one K is equal to 1 by 1, that is C now. So that how to define the specific conductance or conductivity means it is the conductance. It is the conductance of unit length and unit area of cross section of electrolyte. And the specific conductance definition, how to define. So it is the conductance of unit length and unit area of cross section of electrolyte. That's all. Understood? Okay. Next, what are the units for molar conductance and specific conductance? Now keep adding units. Units are mu, molar conductance, and equivalent conductance, cap UQ. What are the units now? Molar conductance, mu is equal to, what is the K into 1000 divided by molarity. Okay, now what is the specific conductance units? Ohm inverse. Centimeter inverse divided by 1000 means it's not a unit. Molarity, what are the units for molarity? Moles per liter, right? Moles per liter. And that implies how it becomes ohm inverse, centimeter inverse. In denominator, liter comes up and liter and mole inverse. These are the units for molar conductance. Now, what are the equivalent conductance units? Cap EQ is equal to K into 1000 divided by normality. So, that what are the units? Ohm inverse, centimeter inverse, and what are the units for normality? Normality units. Number of gram equivalents per liter. Number of gram equivalents. Gram equivalents per liter. Now it becomes ohm inverse, centimeter inverse, liter, and number of Brown equivalents per inverse. These are the units of specific conductance, molar conductance, and equivalent conductance. Specific conductance and molar conductance and equivalent conductance. Okay, right. Next. The next point, measurement of conduction. Here one experiment is there, that is to measure the conductance. How to experimentally measured by using some relations. Next, write down definition. Determination of resistance or conductance of electrolyte experimentally. Note down, experiment is there. Right. Measurement of conductance. Measurement of conductance. Determination of conductance. Hello, now are you able to listen by voice? Is there any disturbance now? Hello?
So it's breaking.
Voice breaking, huh? Okay, now? Now it's okay?
Yes, sir, it's okay.
Okay, measurement of conductance.
Sir, again, it started to crack.
Okay. Measurement of conductance. It's okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, this is experimental derivation is there a little bit.
Sir, again.
So now what is this problem?
Okay. Sir, I think your mic is blocked by something, sir.
Hello? Now it's okay, fine?
Yes, sir.
Oh, okay, this listen now. So this measurement by using some observe the diagram. Try this diagram. And it is also it will come the disabilities and bits.
So we can't hear you.
Okay, I didn't say anything now. Just I'm trying to diagram. Okay, fine. See this. Yeah,
Yeah, see this diagram. One minute. Okay, these are the, this is R2, this is R1, resistance 1, this is R3, R4. So these two are connected to this. This is one. This is O. Here, this is one detector is there. The P is the detector. This is a detector. Detector. So R2 means here we can connect conductor, that means a conductivity cell we are placing in this R2. This is R2, sorry, R2. Conductivity cell is placed. Now we have a measurement of conductance or resistance or R resistance. So now observe this one. Okay, I'm writing a little bit relation matter points, note down small points. So it consists of two resistance. It consists of two resistance. Two resistance R3 and R4. R3 and R4. Comma. A variable resistance R1. Variable resistance. Resistance R4. R1. Variable resistance is R1. R1 and the conductivity cell having unknown resistance and the conductivity cell having unknown resistance, having the unknown unknown resistance R2. Now the Wheatstone bridge Wheatstone bridge is fed by an oscillator O. Down is there a diagram, fed by an oscillator O. That oscillator is source of AC current, is it? Oscillator means a source of AC power. AC power. AC power. In the audio frequency, about the range. Audio frequency range of range 550 to 5000 cycle per second. Cycle per second, you know, frequency is cycle per second. And P is a suitable detector. And P is a suitable detector. It means headphones. Detector means we can observe the headphone and other electric device. You can detect that one. Right.
So your voice is breaking.
Yeah, that is P is the suitable detector. Detector means we can use headphones or any other electric device to measure that sound also. And the bridge is balanced when current is passed through detector. I am repeating again. And the bridge is balanced. Balanced when current passes through.
Sir, can you repeat what does P detect?
Detector under the hello? Tell me.
Sir, can you tell once again what does P detect?
Detector now.
Yes, yeah. Sir, what does it detect? It's a detector, it's written, I know, but what does it detect? Can you repeat if you have said I missed, I think.
Detector means that is a headphones or any other electric device. You can detect the power and power okay. Current balancing. Not only the balancing of balanced the when current passes through the detector. So we can observe that one.
So how is sound produced?
So yeah, that is earphones also is a sound producer means if it is not balanced, sound is keep on produced. If current is balanced total circuit, it will be silent. Okay. By observing that one. Current is not balanced na. In that detector, sound will produce by you observing any electric device or headphones. If it is a balanced, so we can be silent, that only. So that detect anatoma. So under these conditions, okay, finally, under these conditions. So thermal resistance can be determined as unknown resistance that is R2 na, unknown resistance R2 can be determined as R1 R4 by R3. This is the formula. Unknown resistance R2 is equal to R1 R4 divided by R3. Okay, understood or not? But actually, nowadays, this is the old pattern. Nowadays, if the inexpensive conductivity meters are there. So inexpensive conductivity meters are variable which are directly read the conductance or resistance of the solutions, electrolytic solutions. That was the formula. What do we understand? Kappa K is equal to cell constant by resistance. It is actually old model, but nowadays it will
direct, just inexpensive direct converters are there. Direct device. These two can put it in the solution, will come to the resistance.
So your voice is breaking.
See, this is the old pattern only. Nowadays, the latest inexpensive, means less expensive, meters are device, electric device are available. Just only that electric device put in the solution, it will come to know it's the resistance, how much quantity of the resistance of the solution, and how much quantity of the conductance also. If you one factor you will come to know, obviously another can reciprocal of that only, no? Understood or not?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now, go for that. Next other important point is, note down, the conductivity of the solution. Can I skip this place? Note it down, all of you. Next important point. Otherwise, I'm here only, I'm writing. Next point. See, what is important point here? The conductivity of the solution is electrolytic solution. Conductivity of electrolytic solution. Solution of different solutions of different electrolytes. Different electrolytes. In the same solvent. Solvent electrolytic electrolytes are different, but solvent means liquid is same. In the same solvent, and at a given temperature, differs due to the charge and size of the ions. Due to charge and size of the ions. I will explain this one. This is completed, downward. Background also removing. Yes, now. So, size of the conductance and electrolyte series. Now, we are going to discuss about the relation between molar conductance and equivalent conductance, electrolytic conductance with respect to concentration of the solutions. Now, okay, understood all of you? Okay, now we are going to discuss about the effect of dilution or equivalent conductance. Okay, next point is,
ये तो हो गया था। हां मेरा चश्मा।
Right. So relation between, next is relation between conductances versus concentration of the electrolyte. Concentration of the electrolytes. So this is the first one is the first one, specific conductance. Specific conductance. Now, see, the specific conductance means, what is specific conductance? Take this curve also. This is K, specific conductance, and root C, C means concentration of the electrolyte. So it is a directly relation like this. Why it is directly relation, try to understand now. The specific conductance means it depends upon the number of particles present in cubic unit volume, right? Number of particles present in cubic unit volume. So say, this is the cubic unit volume. Cubic unit volume. So specific means is the K is equal to L by A into 1 by R. And that is 1 centimeter and 1 centimeter square area, it becomes conductance only. That is K is equal to L by A into cell constant into C. So what is this specific conductance? Number of ions, number of particles, solute particles. Number of ions present in cubic unit volume is nothing but specific conductance, right? So that means more number of particles or more number of charged particles present in unit length, the specific conductance is more. But whereas in molar conductance and equivalent conductance is depends upon the movability of the ions. Depends upon movability of the ions means on dilution and concentration inversely proportional. Now your specific conductance is directly proportional to the concentration. So what is the specific conductance K? Specific conductance K is directly proportional to the concentration of electrolyte. Concentration of electrolyte. Because that means more number of particles in cubic unit volume, more number of particles increases in unit volume K is increases, right? This is the relation between specific conductance and concentration. Specific conductance and concentration. Now we are going to discuss about the specific conductance and equivalent or molar conductance. So next page, note it down, let's take the snap. Now we're moving to another page. Right. So molar conductance and specific conductance, molar conductance are equivalent conductance. What is the relation between cap M or mu molar conductance and equivalent conductance. Oh, sorry. Equivalent conductance symbol is not this. Equivalent conductance is cap EQ. Cap EQ, right? Versus concentration. Concentration of electrolyte. Concentration of electrolyte. Yes. One Pavitra. Okay. Okay, I'm taking this next page. Okay, I'm showing the next previous page. Oh yeah, I just do something. One minute, wait. It will come like this. Right, note it down. Completed up. Right. Now come to the relation between molar or equivalent conductance and concentration of electrolyte. Concentration of electrolyte. Same, this is the molar conductance and equivalent or equivalent conductance of electrolyte. See this curve. This is the root C. Root C means concentration whole power of. Because for exactly concentration, we don't know. That's why I'm taking that one. And cap EQ or molar conductance. See, what is this like this? Technique curve is a little bit bending now. So this is the electrolyte conductance like this. Okay. So this is the KCl, you can take potassium chloride. This is a barium chloride. PaCl. Barium chloride. It is nickel sulfate, NiSO4. It is weak acid, CH3COOH. Yeah, from this curve, first listen, all of you, explanation will be done. Potassium chloride now, equivalent conductance or molar conductance is high, is the maximum. This is zero concentration. By increasing the concentration means it is high. It is because strong electrolyte. According to Arrhenius theory, it is completely dissociated now. So completely dissociated means the molar and equivalent conductance is high at low concentration also. Next, barium chloride. So barium chloride also ionic compound, right? But why it is less compared to the KCl? In chemical bonding chapter also we have discussed it. So based on the charge as well as the size, just this before this point I given that point only. the conductivity is depends on the charge and size of the ion. Here K plus and Ba plus 2, based on the size, barium chloride is charge also plus 2. You know, larger the quantity of charge, larger the quantity of charge, conductivity is least. That only we discussed in that electronic and electrolytic conductors in the first class. And nickel sulfate. Next come to acetic acid. You know, acetic acid is a weak electrolyte, weak acid. Na? The degree of dissociation is not completely dissociated. So even it is not dissociated, that molar conductance and equivalent conductance is low at certain concentration. You try to understand this component. At zero concentration means infinite dilution. The molar and equivalent conductance of weak electrolyte is maximum. This is the maximum from here. So it's going up also. What is the meaning of this? That equivalent conductance or molar conductance for weak electrolytes at infinite dilution is maximum. Infinite dilution means pouring more water, it is completely dissociated. It is finally the maximum, it exhibits maximum conductance. From this curve, what you are understand, see this. The equivalent conductance, acetic acid is the molar and equivalent conductance is low. But at zero concentration, where the zero concentration, see the diagram. Zero concentration, the sense it is a infinite dilution. It is the maximum for weak electrolyte. So that means the molar conductance is inversely proportional. Molar or equivalent conductance is inversely proportional to concentration. Take now, so conclusion. Molar or equivalent conductance. Molar or equivalent conductances are inversely proportional to concentration of electrolytes.
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, a humble request, sir.
Yeah, yes, tell me.
Sir, can you make this class a bit shorter, sir? We have other work to do also. Like, I don't know. Other people
what?
Have to do some work. Sir, can you finish this class a little bit earlier?
At what time you are to?
So maybe 6:30-ish, 45 something.
Okay. I'll conclude 6:45.
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir.
Yeah,
listen, ma. The molar conductance, we are following content. The molar or equivalent conductances are inversely proportional to concentration of electrolyte. Are directly proportional to dilution, or are directly proportional to the dilution, since molar or equivalent conductance depends on the moment of the ions. So same moment of the ions, now mobility of the ions. Moment means is the mobility of the ions. So the mobility, if it is, for example, 100 members are there in the same one classroom, it is difficult to move, or moment means running. So only one person is there in the class, it can move speed now, or velocity is increased. So that is the thing on dilution, more conductivity, movement of the particles. Even it is not a matter of number of particles. Oh, it's only movement of the ions. That depends upon the movement of the ions. That means on dilution, they can exhibit maximum conductance, molar or equivalent conductance. That is the difference between equivalent conductance and specific conductance. Specific means depends upon the number of particles per unit volume. Here, number of movement of the ions. Movement of the ions. Understood all of you? Okay, next. Note it down, all of you. Next one. It is very, very important what we are going to discuss. Kolra's law. Next, it is very important. Kolra's law. K-O-H-L-R-A-U-S-C-H. Kolra's law. So what is meant by Kolra's law means, for any strong electrolyte or any electrolyte, the equivalent conductance of electrolyte at infinite dilution is equal to algebraic sum of the equivalent conductance of cation and anion at infinite dilution. Understood or not? So what is the statement I'm reading right now? The equivalent conductance of electrolyte so when dissociation complete means for strong electrolyte. So equivalent or molar conductance, both are missing. Equivalent conductance. Equivalent conductance of electrolyte, which is completely dissociated, electrolyte at infinite dilution is the sum of the equivalent conductance of cation and anion at infinite dilution. Infinite dilution. It means equivalent conductance of infinite dilution is the sum of the equivalent conductances of cation and anion at infinite dilution. This is the statement. According to that, so cap is the cap infinity. You know what is the meaning of infinity? Infinite dilution. Or cap zero also. That is equal to lambda. Okay, instead of cap, which is as now, that's why I'm taking cap infinity plus cap infinity, that means lambda infinity. Don't say lambda is wavelength, this is a symbol only. Infinity minus, this is the sum of the cation and anion at infinite dilution. Right? Or you can take them. That means not only molar conductance, equivalent conductance, molar conductance, mu at infinite is equal to cap m plus minus plus cap infinity molar conductance and minus means anion. I'm writing terms explanation there. note it down. Cap infinity is equal to cap infinity or cap zero also. Equivalent conductance. Equivalent conductance. Conductance at infinite dilution or zero concentration. Zero concentration. Zero concentration. Next. What is the lambda infinity plus means? Equivalent conductance of cation at infinite dilution. Similarly, cap infinity minus equivalent conductance of anion at infinite dilution. Right. Infinite dilution. Okay. Note down this formula, all of you. Right. Okay, can I clear this?
So just a minute.
Okay, can I complete? Completed? Sorry. I'm clearing this one. Right. So, you know, degree of dissociation also is there. This is a other important formula. What is the degree of dissociation? Degree of dissociation. Same alpha degree of dissociation already derived in this case. That is Arrhenius theory. That is alpha. Here alpha is equal to degree of dissociation alpha is equal to, take this one, cap C by cap infinity. This is an important formula. Problems are there. What is the degree of dissociation means? Cap C and cap infinity divided by cap infinity, where cap C is equal to equivalent conductance or molar conductance. Equivalent conductance at a certain concentration. Equivalent conductance. Equivalent conductance at certain concentration. What is cap? Infinity means equivalent conductance at infinite dilution. Equivalent conductance at infinite dilution. Infinite dilution. Right? So where cap C is equal to equivalent conductance at certain concentration, and cap infinity means equivalent conductance at infinite dilution. Cap C, cap infinity or cap zero is the same meaning. Next slide. Take this one. Right. So next heading, calculations of absolute ionic mobilities. Next application. Calculation of absolute ionic mobilities. Ionic mobilities. Ionic mobility sum. This mobilities means moment of ions only, right? What is the meaning of mobilities? Say this. So experimentally found that the ionic conductance is directly proportional to its mobility sum. So experimentally determined. Experimentally determined the ionic conductance. Ionic conductance. Okay, ionic only. Ionic conductances. Ionic conductance is directly proportional to. To its mobility and their mobilities. See, for example, suppose here lambda infinity plus, lambda infinity plus means molar conductance, equivalent conductance of cation directly proportional to its mobility. Here U is the mobility of cation, and lambda infinity plus is equal to some proportional constant F. F is the Faraday. Therefore, the mobility can be determined as the mobility of cation is equal to lambda infinity plus by Faraday. Here F is the Faraday. You know the value also. What is F? F is equal to 90 Faraday, that is 96,500 coulombs. Next, what is the another anion? Lambda infinity minus is the equivalent conductance of anion at infinite dilution is directly proportional to its mobility U minus. And therefore, that is directly proportional means next lambda. There it is. That is lambda infinity minus is equal to some proportional constant Faraday into U minus. Therefore, U minus, what is the minus mobility of anion is equal to equivalent, it's the equivalent conductance at infinite dilution by Faraday. So this is the mobility of anion. Now, what is the here U plus sum? U plus is equal to mobility of cation. Mobility of cation and U minus, so what is the mobility of cation? Mobility of cation. So you know what is the lambda plus? Lambda infinity plus means equivalent conductance of cation. Equivalent conductance of cation at infinite dilution. At infinity means at infinite dilution. Similarly, what is the lambda infinity minus is equivalent conductance of anion at infinite dilution. Okay, this is about the calculations of absolute ionic mobilities. Right, next point is the relation between equivalent conductance and molar conductance at infinite dilution. So relation between, go down on this one. Now I'm clearing this page. No doubt. First, I'll take this time. Right. Next heading. Take this. So relation between equivalent conductance, and molar conductance. See this. You know that what is the molar conductance? Okay, equivalent conductance cap EQ is equal to what is the amount? K into 1000 divided by normality, right? Now cap molar conductance is, what is the molar conductance? Mu. I'll simply cap M also. Molar conductance is equal to specific conductance K into 1000 divided by molarity. Now consider equivalent conductance. So equation 1 and equation 2, right? Now consider equation 1. Consider equation 1. Cap EQ is equal to K into 1000 divided by normality, right? We know that what is the normality is equal to molarity into valency or n factor, right? Valency or n factor. So this is the relation, right? Now instead of normality in this equation, you can write n factor. Therefore, equivalent conductance is equal to K into 1000 divided by molarity into n factor. Molarity into n factor. You know what is this one? K into 1000 divided by molarity. K into 1000 divided by molarity. Instead of that, we can write cap M, molar conductance. Therefore, cap equivalent means equivalent conductance is equal to cap M, molar conductance, divided by valency or N factor. N factor or valency. So this is the relation. This is the relation between molar conductance and equivalent conductance. So note down this first. Right. Next, I'll give the same for this only. I'll give the we can apply this for this one chemical compounds. So note it down, all of you. Now I'm clearing this space. So actually, molar conductance apply the Kolber's law for this. Equivalent or molar conductance applying Kolber's law. How to write? See this one. Cap infinity is equal to 1 by Z plus into lambda 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 infinity plus plus 1 by Z minus lambda infinity minus, here where Z plus and Z minus are the charge on cation and on anion, cation and anion. This is the equivalent conductance. So where the this cap infinity is the equivalent conductance at infinite solution. This is for only equivalent conductance. For equivalent conductance. Okay now. So this is the formula. Now I'll give some examples. Cap infinity. Barium chloride. Barium chloride. How to write this one? According to that, what is the charge of cation? Z plus 2, barium plus 2. That means simply you can write 1 by 2 into lambda infinity Ba plus 2 plus this, this expression is very important in the many objective questions are there. So next, what is the charge on anion? Chlorine, Cl minus 1 only, but don't talk 2 chloride ions, only 1 by 1 only. So charge on anion only. So lambda infinity minus, minus is Cl minus. Cl minus, that is expression. Okay, another example. One, next, take the another example. Example 2, that is. Cap infinity. Equivalent conductance of AlCl3. AlCl3 at infinite dilution. How to write? What is the charge of aluminium? Charge of aluminium is plus 3. That means 1 by 3 into infinity, lambda infinity Al plus 3 plus. What is the charge of anion 1 only? 1 by 1 lambda infinity Cl minus. Cl minus. One more I'll give, third example. See, third example. Cap infinity Al2SO4 taken twice. How we take? Aluminium sulfate. What is the charge of cation 3? So that means 1 by 3 lambda infinity Al plus 3 plus. What is the charge on anion? Minus 2. So that means 1 by 2. So lambda infinity SO4 minus 2. This is the expression for equivalent conductance for the electrolytes at infinite dilution. Expression for equivalent conductance of electrolyte at infinite dilution based on, that means by applying Kolder's law. Kolder's law means, what is the Kolder's law? Equivalent conductance of electrolyte at infinite dilution is equal to sum of the molar equivalent conductance of cation and anion at infinite dilution. That is application of Kolder's law. So next point. So for molar conductance, how to express the molar conductance? I'm writing some examples. See this. So clear all of you? Yeah, now I'm clearing this one. Next, molar conductance. For molar conductance, take this. For molar conductance, molar conductance. So what is the, how to write this, how to express this one series? For molar conductance, infinite addition. Here, let M and N be the number of moles of cation and anion. Then how to express cap M infinity is equal to M into lambda infinity M. M means is okay. It is cation. Cation C. I am writing C simply. Plus N into yeah.
So this is the last topic, right?
Yeah, right.
Okay, sir.
N into where your emergency is there, any?
No, sir. I had changed my plans according to 4 to 6 timing. Now it was 5 to 7. Sharma sir told, so I had other work pending, sir.
Okay, fine. I will leave it late.
So yes. Thank you, sir. Okay. Thank you.
Wait a minute. Note it down now. Complete. Let me to finish this. So N into lambda infinity. Anion. This is the anion. See, for example, this is a multiplication of moles. So I'll give this another example. Mu r cap infinity molar at Al2SO4. You can try same example. Now, how many moles? M is the moles of cation, not charge, right? How many moles of aluminium? 2. That's simply 2 into lambda infinity Al plus 3. Plus number of moles of anions, sulfate 3 are there. That means 3 into cap infinity SO4 minus 2. That's what I've done it. Okay. Next, one more example. Take now mu infinity barium chloride, BaCl2. Barium chloride, BaCl2. So that is equal to, so what is the number of moles of barium? 1 only. That means no need to show, right? So cap infinity Ba plus 2 plus how many chloride ions are there? 2 chloride ions. That means 2 into lambda infinity at Cl minus m. This is the expression for molar conductance. Understood the difference between molar conductance and equivalent conductance? So by applying algebraic sum of cation and anion, for molar conductance, the mole should be multiplied with its conductance. And in whereas in case of equivalent conductance, not moles. So the cation and anion divided by the charges, divided by the ions charges. That is a major difference. Okay, now. Hello. Hello students, I'm this. Hello. Listen, yes. My voice. Okay, now according to some of your request, I am closing now. So tomorrow next class, many problems are there in the conductances and the Colles law applications. Colles law applications and problems we'll discuss next class. Any doubt in today class?
Sir, can you show the previous slide? Previous slide, sir.
Previous line. Yeah.
Previous page.
1 minute. Previous page. 1 minute. Wait. It will come. 1 minute. 1 minute. It takes so directly done coming. Okay, take this one. Okay, completed now. Hello.
Sir, thank you.
Now today I'll closing meeting, right? Now we are going to end this meeting. Next class we'll discuss. Okay now.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.